Hello everyone. So our entire world is in a severe crisis. We are facing a pandemic of coronavirus 2019, COVID-19. So on one side, every nation is fighting in the health sector by providing public health responses to face the crisis. On another side, each and every economy of the world and the entire global economy is facing a severe crisis. So most of the nation's government and most of the financial sector stakeholders are in fear that this might lead to a severe recession, or a few people who are pessimistic, or we can't say they are pessimistic, they are also claiming that it might go to a depressionary condition. So amidst all this crisis, each and every nation is announcing an economic package to revive their economy and to protect the people from the wage losses, since we are in a lockdown, people can't go to work and they will be losing their wages and salary. So to protect the people, especially those in the casual labor sector, the government is announcing, most of the governments around the world are announcing many economic response packages. On the similar lines, government of India announced an economic response package called Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Economic Response Package. So in Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Package, our finance minister announced many schemes. Yesterday she announced schemes up to 1.7 lakh crore. Everything was focused in catering to the needs of the loss of wages by the poor, especially those who are daily wage earners and casual laborers. Following that, today morning, our RBI governor announced an economic package from RBI side to face this COVID response. He announced to both monetary steps, that is steps to be taken on the liquidity side and steps to be taken on the regulatory side to control this COVID response. There was a 75 basic points repo cut, which is one of the highest repo cut ever. So 75 basic point repo cut is considered to be phenomenal. So let us decode why RBI has announced such a package, and let us see what are all the various announcements given by RBI. This video is presented to you by Adil, Baig. I'm faculty in KingMakers IAS Academy. Topics covered in this video are the economic crisis, which was before the COVID-19 crisis, the existing slowdown, the present economic crisis because of this COVID-19, RBI's response to this crisis and the package announced by RBI. The long-term repo operation is the term which was used by RBI. Let us understand what is long-term repo operation, which is difference from the existing liquidity adjustment facility. Cash reserve ratio leeway, which is a new scheme against announced by RBI. Let us see what is the CRR leeway. Corridor of monetary policy. So this is a new term against discussed in this video. Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Package announced by Finance Minister and Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Ann. These two schemes announced by Finance Minister is also covered in this video. So now let us go to the RBI's plan. So before going into this RBI's response, we have to understand the current economic situation. Our current economy before COVID-19, our Indian economy even before this COVID-19, faced a severe liquidity crisis. There was a liquidity crisis and there was crunch of liquidity. People were not having enough money in their hand. Since there is a liquidity crisis, there is a fall in demand. Since the demand has fallen, the supply had to be cut off. So since the supply is being cut off, there is less production. So since there is less production and hence low GDP growth. So GDP is nothing but what? It is the total value of all goods and services produced in an economy. If there is less production, then there will be surely a low GDP growth, and that has led to the slowdown. So we were facing a slowdown even before this coronavirus crisis in October, November, December time. So our government was bringing in a lot of schemes as a response to tackle this economic slowdown. So another bad side of this economic slowdown is an unemployment crisis. Since there is a cutoff in production, since they are producing less, they are also laying off a lot of employees. Since with less employee, we can produce less. So this layoff has led to an unemployment crisis too. This unemployment crisis, along with the economic slowdown was creating severe problem to Indian economy even before the COVID, and now this COVID-19 had made the situation further worse for Indian economy. Our economy, which was expected to grow at 6%, was downgraded to 5% and then to 4.8. Now it people are speculating that it will be going below 4 after this COVID. So a few analysts even said that it is very difficult to even expect a 3% growth rate after this COVID crisis. So among all this, so post-COVID outbreak, so already our economy was in a bad shape because of this liquidity crisis. And this liquidity crisis and economic slowdown and unemployment crisis has further become worse because of this COVID-19. So there is a fear of a recession or a depression. You all remember this diagram, right? We all studied this diagram of business cycle, where we'll reach a boom here, boom, then recession, depression and recovery. So we were seeing. So fall in the growth rate is called as recession. If this fall in the growth rate leads to the fall in GDP, if there is negative GDP growth, that is, now this year our GDP was at $2.9 trillion. If 2020 our GDP becomes $2.8 trillion, so which is called as negative growth. If this $2.9 trillion GDP is becoming 3.2, then it is called as growth rate with 4% or 5%. But if this 2.9 trillion become 2.8 trillion in the next year, so that is called as negative growth rate, negative growth. So there is fall in total output. So this fall in total output or negative growth rate is called, if it continues for two consecutive quarters, it is called as a recession. So recession can be defined in two ways, either in terms of growth rate or in terms of actual GDP. So in actual GDP, we might face a severe recession, and if it is not controlled, that might lead to depression. So when an economy is going towards recession, government should announce schemes to recover it back and take and bring it here. We already saw this. If it is going, so this is boom, this is recession, depression and recovery. So when an economy is going from boom to recession, we have to take steps and bring it back to recovery stage. If these steps are not taken, it will go to depression. So all the governments are taking steps here to prevent the economy going from recession to depression. So our government also announced the schemes on the same lines. So this is the fear now. So already existing slowdown might further worsen the situation, and it might lead to a very big crisis of demand, because of this COVID, we are in a quarantine. So we are not going to our work. So since we are not going to our work, we are not getting our wages. Since we are not getting our wages, we will not be spending. So there will be huge fall in demand, and there will be huge fall in consumption. Fall in demand and consumption will further lead to fall in supply, and that will might lead to negative GDP growth. So this is the thing. So this negative GDP growth might lead to severe recession or depression. So this is what the economists are telling now of this crisis. So since there is a, so this is one way. Another way, since all the production outlet are closed, and if this shutdown is extending, we might face a supply crisis too. There might be some supply side breaks also. Even though we are in quarantine, we might be needing food and basic amenities. If the supply is not provided, that might lead to fall in supply, and that might also will lead to inflation. So we are in a threat of facing both demand pull and cost push inflation. So which is very severe. Hence, at this stage, government has announced a package to revive our economy from recession and take it towards recovery. So we will see, initially we will see the response made by RBI first, and then we will go to the response taken by the government. So the steps taken by RBI, we will see the steps taken by RBI first. So these were all the objectives given by RBI today. Expanding the liquidity in the system, sizable to ensure that financial market and institutions are able to function normally in the face of COVID-related dislocations. So there is a severe liquidity crisis which you already saw. So RBIs keep having that in mind and bringing in this steps. At the same time, if you could see the stock market and other financial market, people are selling off their shares. There is a huge sell-off of shares in the stock market and capital market, and that is leading to the fall in the capital available to the businesses. So our businesses are in severe crisis of availability of working capital. So that is one side. People are selling off a lot of assets in the share market, and they are investing all their money in US dollars or gold. Hence, keeping that in mind and liquidity crisis in mind, RBI is taking the decision. Secondly, reinforcing the monetary transmission. See, RBI already announced, even before this COVID crisis, RBI announced the repo rate cut of 135 basic points, and now they have announced a 75. So total 210 basic points cut repo rate has been announced within a span of 14 months, and which is historic. So never in RBI's history, RBI has announced the 210 basic points cut within a span of 14 months. Even though RBI has cut this much, the banks are not transferring this repo rate cut to the cut in their lending rates. So lending rates of banks have reduced only up to 49 basic points. So according to our recent economic survey, it has reduced only 49 basic points. And hence, in order to increase this monetary transmission, RBI is taking certain innovative steps. So we will see what are all those innovative steps taken by RBI. Easing the financial stress caused by COVID disruption by relaxing the repayment pressure. So people are not having jobs, and there is a huge layoff going on in various sectors. So people will not have money to pay back, and there is no demand, and hence these companies also should have to cut down their supplies. With all this crisis in mind, businesses will find it difficult to repay the loan whichever they borrowed, and people will also find it difficult to repay the loan because businesses are not having any business, so they cannot repay their loan. And people here who got personal loans, they are not getting their salaries now, and they cannot repay the loan. So what the RBI has done is that they have announced the 3-month deferment of EMI payments. So improving the functioning of market in the view of high volatility experienced with the onset and spread of pandemic. So we have to control, and there is a control this volatility too. There is a huge volatility because of this COVID-19, because people are taking away their money from the capital market and they are investing it in dollars, gold, and in Japanese yen, because they consider them to be some stable asset and inflation adjusted. Hence, they are all investing their money there to make it safe. So there is a huge volatility now in the market because of this, and there is also a huge fall in the oil prices too. So fall in oil prices is another reason which might create ripple effects within our economy. So keeping in mind this fall in the oil prices on one side, and keeping in mind this huge fall in the investments in the capital market, and people investing their money in their dollars. People are investing money in the dollars because they consider dollar to be a safe investment, and it will always have value. So people are taking away their money from capital market and investing them in dollars. So that is the crisis which is going on now. So these are all the monetary policy tools available in the hands of RBI to take decision with respect to the liquidity. They are having various tools, and we know in our UPSC preparation we have classified them as quantitative tools and qualitative tools. So RBI is used to use some of this tool to carry out the liquidity adjustments. So in today's announcement, what they have done is they have made certain changes in the bank rate, cash reserve ratio, and they have announced a new kind of operation. So we already saw many new things are being added up. We saw Operation Twist, which was in, brought in recently in last December. So apart from that Operation Twist, government has announced a new thing now, which is long-term repo operation. So long-term repo operation is a mixture of open market operation and liquidity adjustment facility. So it is a new kind of an initiative by the bank, and we'll see what is that. So there is an announcement in liquidity adjustment facility rates also. So let us see. And so hence, before this prelims, government has announced a few more new monetary policy tools. One is operation twist, which we have to study for the prelims. And then RBI has announced this long-term repo operation, which is a new instrument, non-conventional instrument, so that we have to study. So whenever RBI does certain non-conventional steps, questions are being asked from that non-conventional step. So be ready for that. So let us see the first step. RBI has announced targeted long-term repo operation. So this long-term repo operation is a new term which we are hearing. So let us see what is this long-term repo operation. So we all know that bank get their long-term loans at bank rate and short-term loans at repo rate. From whom? From RBI. From RBI, banks get long-term loan and short-term loans. So long-term loans are in bank rate and short-term loans are in repo rate. So generally, RBI sets the bank rate, set these bank rate to be higher than the repo rate. So always the bank rate is higher than repo rate. So that so this is what RBI does, and hence whenever the banks are borrowing money to borrowing money from RBI to give it to people, they borrow from bank rate for the long term fund and at repo rate for the short term fund under liquidity adjustment facility. We all know these basics. These are all the basics regarding the monetary policy tools. And now, in long-term repo operation, what RBI is doing is, RBI is providing providing long-term capital support. That is, it is allowing banks to take long-term capital of 1 year and 3 year tenure period. 1 year and 3 year tenure period or maturity. So 1 year or 3 year tenure period maturity is a long-term fund. So RBI is providing these long-term funds at repo rate. Generally, these used to be provided at bank rate. See, bank rate was 5.4 and repo rate was at 5.15 before this announcement. So before today's announcement, this was the condition. Bank rate was higher than the repo rate. So when RBI, when banks are borrowing long-term loans from RBI, they used to borrow at bank rate at 5.4%. So when they are borrowing at 5.4%, so these two rates, this long-term and short-term rates, will have their effect in the lending rates of bank. See, when bank are borrowing money at 5.4%, surely when they are giving loans out of this money, they will be fixing a higher price. See what bank does. Bank is getting money as deposits from people. At one side, it is getting money as deposits from people, and another side, it is getting long-term loans from RBI at bank rate. So it will provide some deposit rate for depositors. So what banks will do, they will fix, so with the money whichever they collected now from the depositors and the long-term loans borrowed from RBI, they would have created a capital. So they will be lending this capital to the people whoever are asking us loan. So when they are lending these loans, they will fix the interest rate in such a way that they earn profit. So they are borrowing money at bank rate from the RBI, and they are borrowing money at the deposit rate from the depositors. So this lending rate will be fixed in such a way that it is over and above these two. So bank rate and deposit rate will determine the amount of percentage of money which is fixed for the loan given to the people. So now what is the crisis here? RBI has announced 135 basic points cut before this COVID crisis, but the transmission was only at 49 basic points. So there was no monetary transmission. So in order to enhance this monetary transmission, RBI has announced this long-term repo operation. Now in long-term repo operation, what is happening? Banks can borrow this long-term loans of 1 year and 3 year tenure premium at repo rate. So repo rate is going to be less than the bank rate. So banks can borrow long-term funds at repo rate, which is less than bank rate. Since it is less than bank rate, banks will transfer this reduced. So banks will transfer this reduced interest rate to people. So what RBI is thinking is, when banks are able to get long-term loans at repo rate, which is less than bank rate, they will also reduce their lending rates. Now, if through this long-term repo operation, RBI is giving long-term loans of 1 year and 3 year period to bank instead of bank rate at repo rate, hence they will be reducing their lending rates. If they are reducing their lending rates, more loans will be bought by the people. If more loans is bought, more liquidity will go into the economy. If more liquidity is going, that will create more demand, and that demand will lead to GDP growth. If there is more demand, what will happen? More supply will be done to cater the demand. If more supply means more production means more GDP growth. So this is what RBI is doing. In order to save this economy from this slowdown, they are doing all these steps. So it will not only ensure in increasing the liquidity, but will also ensure in transfer of the repo rate cut, that is repo rate cut into the lending rates cut. So it will also ensure the monetary transmission. So that is what RBI is doing using this long-term repo operations. So in long-term repo operation, what RBI is doing, it is planning to pump in 1 lakh crore money through this. So they are planning to pump in 1 lakh crore. So 1 lakh crore rupees of money will be pumped from RBI to bank in the form of long-term loans, that is 1 year and 3 year period at repo rate, which is less than bank rate. Hence, bank will be getting money at lower rate at repo rate. Since they are getting money at lower rate, they will be reducing their lending rate. So this is the link between this targeted long-term repo operation and the recent announcement and reduction in monetary policy transmission. So with the onset of COVID-19, India has ignited the large so we have seen how it is going to reduce the interest rates. Now there is another dimension to this long-term operations also. So if you would note, RBI announced this long-term repo operation in January itself. They announced in January end, and in the February they announced that they are going to conduct this long-term repo operation of the tune of 1 lakh crore. But so this was announced already, keeping in the existing slowdown. They didn't announce this with respect to COVID. So they announced this with respect to existing slowdown which our economy was facing. Now with this advent of this coronavirus, what RBI has done is, they in apart from the existing 1 lakh crore long-term repo operation, they have added an important clause to this. The clause is the onset of rapid propagation. What it has led? It has led to severe sell-offs, large sell-off in the domestic equity and forex market and in stock markets too. There is a large sell-off. So sell-off means people are taking out their investments done in the stock market. People are taking away their investments done in the equity market, bond market and forex market, and investing all that money in safe havens like dollars or in gold to save their investments. So this is the crisis which is happening. Because of this huge sell-off, the firms are now facing the crisis of what? They are facing the crisis of working capital. So they are not having working capital, that is short-term funds. So firms have lost a lot of capital because of this huge sell-off by the investors. Since investors are taking away their money from this capital market and investing in the safe havens, they have lost, these firms have lost a huge working capital. So this is the crisis prevailing. So now what RBI has done is, அவங்க வந்து ஒரு இனோவேஷன் கொண்டு வராங்க. தே ஹவ் பிராட் இன் அ வெரி குட் இனோவேஷன் ஹியர். வாட் தே ஆர் டூயிங் இஸ், த லிக்விடிட்டி அவைல்டு அண்டர் த ஸ்கீம் பை பேங்க்ஸ் ஹேஸ் டு பி டெப்ளாய்டு இன் இன்வெஸ்ட்மெண்ட் கிரேட் கார்பரேட் பேண்ட்ஸ், கமர்ஷியல் பேப்பர் அண்ட் டிபென்ச்சர்ஸ். ஸோ வாட் ஆர்பிஐ இஸ் டெல்லிங் இஸ், ஸோ நவ் ஆர்பிஐ இஸ் கோயிங் டு பம்ப் இன் 1 lakh crore ஆஃப் மணி அட் ரெப்போ ரேட். 1 lakh crore ஆஃப் மணி ஆஸ் லாங் டேர்ம் பாரோயிங்ஸ் to banks at repo rate. Hence, bank will be getting huge liquidity now to give it to people at low interest rate, since they are getting at repo rate. So, the banks will be having liquidity now to give at low interest rate. So, this was the announcement earlier. Now, they have added this additional clause now. So, according to this additional clause, banks have to deploy this money in the corporate bond and commercial papers. So that those firms which lost their capital because of the sell-off, they get this money. So, ஒரே கல்லில் ரெண்டு மாங்கான்னு சொல்கிற மாதிரி, இன் திஸ் சிங்கிள் மூவ் வாட் ஆர்பிஐ ஹேஸ் டன் இஸ் ஆர்பிஐ ஹேஸ் இன்க்ரீஸ்டு த மானிட்ரி பாலிசி டிரான்ஸ்மிஷன். அதாவது தே இன்க்ரீஸ் த டிரான்ஸ்மிஷன், தட் இஸ் இட் வில் இன்டியூஸ் பேங்க் டு ரெடியூஸ் தேர் லெண்டிங் ரேட்ஸ் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தி லோ ரெப்போ ரேட்ஸ். தட் இஸ் ஒன் திங். இன் அன் அதர் திங், தே ஆல்ரெடி பேங்க்ஸ் ஆர் இன் த சிவியர் லிக்விடிட்டி கிரைசிஸ் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் த ஹியூஜ் என்பிஏஸ். Since they are having huge NPA, they are having liquidity crisis, now they will have additional liquidity to lend more. And the third point is important point. Since, because of this COVID-19 crisis, there is a huge fall in stock market and firms are losing capital because investors are preferring other places to invest. So, what is happening now? RBI has mandated all the banks that whatever liquidity you are getting with this long-term repo operation, you have to invest that money in the corporate bonds, commercial papers and non-convertible debentures, so that the firms who lost their investment, who lost their capital because of their sell-offs, get enough capital for their day-to-day functioning. So, in single move, RBI is aiming to address all these three problems. So, that's why this method is considered to be an innovative method. So, ஒரே மூவ்லே என்ன பண்ணுறாங்க, இத்தனை நாளாக இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் ரேட் வந்து பேங்க் குறைக்கவே இல்லை, லெண்டிங் ரேட், அந்த லெண்டிங் ரேட்டையும் குறைக்க வைக்கிறாங்க. ஏன்னா அவங்க வந்து ரெப்போ ரேட்டில் கம்மியாக தர்றதுனால. இன்னொரு சைடில் திஸ் பேங்க்ஸ் விக்கு ஆல்ரெடி லிக்விடிட்டி கிரைசிஸ் இருந்தது, ஏன்னா அவங்கக்கிட்ட ஹியூஜ் என்பிஏ இருந்ததுனால லிக்விடிட்டி கிரைசிஸில் இருந்தாங்க. இப்போ அந்த என்பிஏவும் கிடைக்க போகுது. அட் தி சேம் டைம் இப்போ நீங்கள் ரீசெண்டாக பார்த்துருப்பீங்க, இந்த ஸ்டாக் மார்க்கெட் ஃபால்லாம் நடந்ததுனால ஸோ ஃபர்ம்ஸ் ஆர் லூசிங் கேபிட்டல். அந்த ஃபர்ம்ஸ் எல்லாருமே நவ் தே வில் பி கெட்டிங் த கேபிட்டல் பிகாஸ் ஆர்பிஐ ஹஸ் மேண்டேட்டட் தட் திஸ் 1 lakh crore has to go there. So, this is this innovative step behind the targeted long-term repo operation. Now, next we'll go to the cash reserve ratio. You know that what is cash reserve ratio? Amount of money that each bank have to deposit with respect to RBI. So, from their net demand and time liabilities, allowed from all the deposits, a part of the deposit should be deposited with RBI. It was at 4%. That is, if a bank is getting 100 rupees as deposit, so deposit as 100 rupees by a depositor is the demand liability. So, both demand liability and time liability, that is fixed deposit together. So, if a bank is getting 100 rupees as deposit, they have to give 4 rupees to RBI as cash reserve ratio. That was the existing norm. Hence, this bank will be left with 96 rupees to give as loan. So, by this, by increasing or decreasing, RBI can control the amount of money which banks are having to lend loans. At the same time, this is also a tool to control the money multiplier effect. You know money multiplier concept, it is there in NCRT. So, it is also a tool to control the money multiplier, that is how much money is there in the circulation. How the money in circulation is increasing because of this deposits. So, now what RBI has announced that the existing 4% cash reserve ratio will be reduced to 3%. So, they are reducing 1%. Earlier, banks used to give 4 rupees to RBI. Now, they have to give only 3 rupees, which means that this bank is saving 1 rupee for each 100 rupees deposit. So, if they are able to save 1 rupee for each 100 rupees deposit, cumulatively, this will add up to 1.37 lakh crore of additional money available for bank to give as loan. So, earlier bank used to have 96 rupees to give as loan, now they will have 97 rupees to give as loan. So, this will add up to the liquidity which the bank can give as loan. So, already through this long term repo operation, RBI is bringing 1 lakh crore, now another 1.37 lakh crore is available to bank to give as loan. So, this is the second step which the RBI has announced today. It has decided to reduce the CRR by 100 basic points to 3%. Of the net demand and time liabilities. So, reduction of CRR will release up to 1.3 lakh crore rupees. So, reduction of 1% CRR means more money will be in the hands of bank now. That more money will be, bank will be in the situation to lend that as loans. So, this is available only for a year, to till the next March 26, 2021 only, this flexible gap, this 3% cash reserve ratio is announced. So, if you could see in February, even before this COVID crisis, RBI has announced a new CRR leeway scheme. So, if you could see February current affairs, you will be seeing this term called CRR leeway. So, now let us see the what is this CRR leeway. In CRR leeway, the CRR leeway was announced keeping the existing economic crisis in mind and already existing slowdown in mind. It was not announced as a part of the present COVID-19 crisis, but still I am explaining because of the preliminary point of view. So, the CRR leeway means, in the CRR leeway, RBI is giving new formula to calculate the net demand and time liabilities for a period of 5 years. So, that is till 2025. So, for the period of 5 years, this is going to be the formula for NDTL. They are giving a new formula for NDTL. Now, let us go to the existing concept of NDTL. Existing concept of net demand and time liabilities is that whatever the deposits taken for in the form of current deposits and that is savings deposits and fixed deposits. So, these are all the two put together is net demand and time liability for a bank, which bank has to pay. So, let us take an example that a bank is having a deposit of 100 rupees. So, that is the net demand and time liability. With the existing formula, this will be the net demand and time liability. Let us take 50 rupees from savings deposit and 50 rupees from fixed deposit. It is getting 100 rupees as the total deposit and this will be the net demand and time liability. In the existing formula, it have to pay this 4 rupees to RBI. So, they will be paying this 4 rupees to RBI as CRR. Okay. Now, you parallelly, so this is the existing thing. Now, you consider the an example where this bank, now they are left with 96 rupees to give loans. So, don't take SLR in mind for the example purpose. Now, they are having this existing 90 rupees to give us loans. So, what this bank is doing, this is giving loans to 10 rupees of loan to automobile sector, another 10 rupee of loans to housing sector, another 10 rupee of loans to MSME sector. So, totally they gave 30 rupees loan to these three sector, 30 rupee loans to automobile, housing and MSME sector. So, which is 30 rupees. So, what RBI is telling is, new NDTL formula is existing NDTL minus loans given to automobile, housing and MSME. So, this is the new formula. So, what is the existing NDTL now with our example? It is 100 rupees. Loans given to these three sector, how much? 10, 10, 10, which we saw here. So, that will be 30 rupees. So, the new NDTL will be 70 rupees. So, what RBI is telling, instead of calculating NDTL as 100 and taking 4 rupees out of it as CRR, you take this new 70 as NDTL and give 4% from this as CRR. So, 4% from this will be 2.8. Okay. So, 4% from this is going to be 2.8. So, with the existing CRR, banks will have to pay 4 rupees to RBI and they will be left with 96 rupees to give a loan. Now, they will be giving only 2.8 to RBI and they will be left with how much? They will be left with 97.2 rupees. So, they will be left with 97.2 rupees, which is 1.2 rupees extra. So, all the banks are getting additional 1.2 rupees extra because of this, which they can give as loan. So, earlier they were giving 96 rupees for loan, now they are having 97 rupees to give as loans. So, banks are getting more liquidity. So, with this more liquidity, they will be getting giving more loans. So, this is one method where ore kalla rendu manga mari. So, in a single stone, you are breaking two mangoes where a part of this additional, they are encouraging the banks to give more loans to automobile, housing and MSME in order to boost liquidity and boost demand. So, that was the existing crisis. And parallelly, they are also providing an additional leeway for the banks to give more loans. So, leeway of 1.2 rupees additionally, which they can give more loans to more sectors. By this, more money will be pumped into the economy and more money supply and more demand and more GDP growth. So, that is the logic behind the cash reserve ratio leeway announced in February. So, this was announced even before the COVID-19. So, now after this COVID-19, apart from this CRR leeway, RBI has announced a reduction of CRR by 1%, that is 100 basic points. Now the CRR is going to be 3%. So earlier banks has to give 4%, 4, and that became 2.8. With the present CRR, what they are going to do? So from this remaining 70, they will be paying only 3%. That is going to be 2.1 rupees. So only 2.1 rupees is going to be the CRR amount. So they will be having more money. So this is the concept of this. See, up to this, it is the new announcement and this is the existing announcement. So have that in mind. So everything is for the preliminary. So marginal standing facility. So there was an announcement recently about this marginal standing facility. You know what is marginal standing facility? If the banks are exhausting their existing options under liquidity adjustment facility to pledge their government security to get the short term loans, they can get avail loans from marginal standing facility, which is going to be at the rate which is higher than the repo rate. So MSF rate will always be higher than the repo rate. So they can pledge, so they can get more money from RBI through marginal standing facility by taking their government securities from SLR. So in liquidity adjustment facilities, bank can pledge their government securities which they are having over and above the SLR requirement, that is 18.25% of net demand and time liability. In marginal standing facility, banks are allowed to breach this SLR norms and take the government security within this SLR to pledge. So, and hence it is a penal rate over and above the repo rate. So, this was the existing condition. So, this was the existing condition of MSF. So, there was a rider for this MSF, that is banks can take only 2% of the SLR. That is SLR norm is 18.25 currently. So they can breach up to 2% only. That is, they can go only up to 16.25 and they can take this 2% of money from SLR, that is government securities from SLR, and pledge with RBI to borrow the short-term fund. Now, RBI has increased this 2% norm to 3%. That is, banks can take up to 3% of their SLR money to, that is SLR money, the SLR government security to pledge with RBI and get the short term loans. So MSF is nothing but taking away the government security which was kept as SLR and pledging that with RBI and getting short term money at MSF rate. So this was the concept of MSF. Now earlier it was they can take only up to 2%. Now they can take additional 1%. So earlier 2% norm has become 3% now. So under the marginal standing facility, banks can borrow overnight at their discretion by dripping up to 2% of their SLR. Now with this COVID crisis, they are allowing them to borrow up to 3%. So more money they can borrow again. So this is another margin they are giving by this another. So another 1% of their net demand and time liabilities is freed now. So already because of the reduction of CRR, RBI freed 1.37 lakh crore rupees because of reduction of CRR to 1%. They freed 1.37 lakh to crore. Now they are giving a flexibility of another 1% within the SLR under marginal standing facility. So another 1.37 lakh crore is available. And already we saw long term repo operations. Their government is trying to pump in a 1 lakh crore rupees. So totally 74 lakh crore rupees is being pumped. So RBI, through these small tweakings and innovative announcement, they are planning to pump in 3.74 lakh crore rupees. Government on another side, they announced another 1.7 lakh crore rupees. So under Garib Kalyan Yojana, under Garib Kalyan Package, government announced the 1.7 lakh crore to pump in. So this is monetary policy decision of RBI where they are going to pump in 3.7 lakh crore. Government through their Garib Kalyan Yojana, they are trying to pump in 1.7 lakh crore. So totally government is going to pump in 5.4 lakh crore liquidity into the economy. So 5.4 lakh crore liquidity into the economy is going to be pumped, which is going to increase the demand in a huge way, and that will bring our economy out of the slowdown. So this is one of the most innovative way of RBI. And finally, Monetary Policy Committee decided to reduce the repo rate. So repo rate was at 5.15 points. Now it was reduced from 5.15 points to by 75 points. So it was reduced up to 75 points to 4.4. So repo rate is currently 4.40. So there is a 75 basic points cut in repo rate. If there is a cut in repo rate, there will be a cut in lending rates. If there is a cut in lending rate of bank, what will happen? The lending rate is cut means more loans will be borrowed. More loans will be borrowed means more money supply. Money supply will increase. If there is an increase in money supply, that will boost the economy from low demand. So there will be huge demand, and that will lead to inflation. We are having low inflationary condition, and this will boost the inflationary condition and demand. So this will bring out our economy from the low consumption economy, low consumption crisis. So consumption rate has fallen very badly. 40-year low value was seen recently. So it will bring out our economy from the demand crisis. So that is why RBI has reduced the interest rate up to 75 basic points. So now you have to understand one thing. So earlier our reverse repo was at how much? Reverse repo was at 4.9. repo rate, so this is reverse repo. Reverse repo was 4.9, repo rate was at 5.15, and marginal standing facility rate was at 5.4. so this was the earlier rates. So if you could see here, the band gap, that is the corridor kept by the corridor which is being maintained here, is 25 basic points here and 25 basic points here. So this is the corridor of monetary policy. They used to call it as corridor of monetary policy. So the corridor of monetary policy was 50 basic points, 25 between reverse repo and repo, and 25 between repo and MSF. We already knew this, but now in the latest announcement, what RBI has done is the reverse repo is at so the repo rate was brought down to 4.4 by 75 basic points cut, but the reverse repo, so logically speaking, the reverse repo should have been at 4.15 if they are going to maintain this 25, but they further reduced the reverse repo. So reverse repo was brought down to from 4.9 to 4%. So they have reduced the reverse repo by 90 basic points and reverse repo by 75 basic points. MSF band is maintained constant, that is now presently the MSF is 4.65 only. So they are maintaining the 25 gap here, but the gap here has become 40. So now the corridor, the monetary policy corridor, became 75 basic points. So you have to think, earlier the corridor was equal, 25 year and 25 year, and it was 50. So RBI maintained this corridor constant between the both repo rate and reverse repo and repo rate and MSF. Now they have increased the corridor between the repo and reverse repo to 40, but repo and MSF is at only 25. So why there is a huge gap between repo and reverse repo? Generally, whenever the repo rates are cut, whatever the rate repo rate are cut, the same rate the reverse repo also cut. So that is the logic. But now they have cut repo rate by 75 and reverse repo by 90. So this is a new thing. So why this happened and why there is an increase in the monetary policy corridor? So the increase in monetary policy corridor is because of this liquidity crisis again. I'll explain that. So what bank used to do is, see, we are facing this twin balance sheet problem. You know this twin balance sheet problem, where corporates are facing a huge crisis and there is a huge NPA crisis. Hence the banks are reluctant to give their loans to corporates. So banks, instead of giving loans to corporates, what they are doing, they are investing their money in government security, and they are, whatever liquidity they are getting, what they are doing, instead of lending that as loans, they are not lending that as loan, they are investing their money in government security. And they are, which we already saw in economic survey, we saw this, there was threefold rise in the government security investment by bank, because they want to make their money safe. In another way, what they are doing, they are using this reverse repo option. So what is this reverse repo option? In reverse repo, under marginal standing facility, RBI allows the banks to park. So banks are allowed to park their excess of liquidity to RBI. So banks are allowed to park their excess liquidity to RBI, and RBI will pay interest rate of reverse repo to banks for this. So whatever liquidity banks had, what they were doing, they were investing their money in government security, and there was threefold increase in the government security investment in 2019-20 financial year. And banks up to 3.2 lakh crore rupees, bank parked up to 3.2 lakh crore of excess liquidity with RBI under reverse repo operation, because they want to protect their capital. They are reluctant to lend their money to other firms. Hence, they are protecting their money by investing their money in the safe havens like government securities and reverse repo operation. In order to discourage this reverse repo operation investments by banks, RBI has decreased the reverse repo. If there is a decrease in reverse repo, then it means that they will be getting low returns. So reverse repo is decreased. So if reverse repo is decreased more, they will get only 4% returns there. But if they are able to lend money, give the money as loans to these firms, they will be getting more interest rate. In order to discourage the parking of excess liquidity in the RBI, RBI has decreased the reverse repo. So now they will be getting only 4% now. And so instead of this, bank will be lending money to the firms who are asking for loans. So this is the logic behind it. Since banks are investing their money in the safe havens like government security and in the reverse repo operations, they were not transferring this repo rate cuts into lending rates cut. Whenever the RBI cuts the repo rate, they have to transfer that in lending rate cut. But we already saw 135 was cut here, and lending rates were cut only up to 49. So there was no monetary policy transmission. There was this non-transmission of monetary policy. So because they were parking their money in the safe havens, only if the money is released from the safe havens, this bank will be having money to lend to the firms. And hence, keeping that in mind, RBI has reduced this reverse repo. Now they will be getting low returns in reverse repo, and hence they will park their money, they will lend their money to the firms who are asking, and that will increase the money supply. And that will be, since it is increasing the money supply, that will boost the demand and bring back the economy from slowdown. So this is the reason why RBI has widened their monetary policy corridor from earlier 50 to 75, and they have widened this reverse repo corridor. So this is the logic behind the widening of the repo and reverse repo. They reduced the policy repo rate under liquidity adjustment facility by 75 basis points to 4.4. We already saw this, and marginal standing facility was brought down to 4.65. That is, see, repo rate was cut down by 75 basic points, reverse repo was cut down by 90 basic points, and marginal standing facility by 4.65 basic points. Further, consequent upon the widening of LAF corridor, we already saw they widened the LAF corridor in the previous slide, 90 basic points. So, Monetary Policy Committee has decided to continue with their accommodative stance. Accommodative stance means they wanted to accommodate the economy by reducing the repo rate. So, they have decided to continue their accommodative stance as long as it is necessary to revive growth. If you could see the speech of RBI governor, he said that we have announced this a lot of liquidity surplus. See, already RBI is going to pump in 3.74 lakh crore by the operation. Government is planning to pump in 1.7 lakh crore. So this is going to be 5.7 lakh crore increase in money supply. If there is huge increase in money supply, that will boost the demand and that will bring out the economy in slowdown. But that can also lead to inflation. That can also lead to inflation because of huge money supply. So what governor said that we are controlling the money supply by keeping growth rate and inflation in mind. He also stressed that that particular word when he said it. So till now we were seeing the liquidity management measures like long term repo operations, reduction in CRR, and we also saw the CRR leeway. Then we saw the widening of liquidity adjustment facility by increasing the amount they can take away from statutory liquidity ratio, and then we saw this policy rate cut. And now we are going to the regulatory and supervision related operations. Initially, what RBI did was they reduced the moratorium on term loans. So that is whatever loans borrowed by people, whatever loans borrowed by the firms, they are going to get 3 months exemptions, 3 month exemption from EMI payment, 3 months exemption from EMI, that is interest and principal payments. So all the loans, whatever loans the banks, all the scheduled commercial banks, they included every financial institution, scheduled commercial bank, RRBs, that is RRBs, then cooperative banks, then we also, they also included NBFCs, whatever entities and whatever loans being borrowed, in all the loans, there is going to be 3 month exemption from EMI payment. So whatever loans people borrowed, education loans, farm loans, agriculture loans, auto loans, housing loans, they no need to pay any EMI for the next upcoming 3 months. So RBI has given this 3 months exception, keeping this COVID-19 in mind. Because if this exemption is given, see, on one side banks are not having business, on another side people are not having jobs, so both they are not having money to pay back the loans for the next 3 months because of the crisis, and hence RBI is giving this exemption. With this, they will be having money to spend for themselves. RBI also announced this deferment of working capital facilities, that are the interest payments. So what is this working capital? You know, working capital means capital borrowed for day-to-day operation. See, long-term capital is for capital investment, that is to increase the company size and other things. Working capital means the money borrowed for day-to-day operation, like payment of salaries of employees or payment of dues or procurement of raw materials, like this. This is the working capital needs. So for this, many firms would have borrowed loans for working capital. So all the loans which were borrowed for catering this working capital, for all that loans, RBI is exempting interest payments, only interest payments for 3 months. See, for all, in general, all loans, it is exempting the, see, in gen, for general long-term loans, it is exempting the 3 months EMI. Working capital loans are generally short-term loans. For short-term loans, they are exempting only the interest payments. For long-term loans, they are exempting both interest payments and principal for 3 months. For short-term loans, only the interest payment is being deferred here, which you have to note down clearly. Then, you already know, see, there is a repeat of point. You note this. Net stable funding ratio, according to Basel norms, Basel norm, every bank should maintain the 100% net stable funding ratio by March 2020. So this was the date given by RBI. So within March 2020, every bank should have achieved their, April 1. So April 1 was the target. So by April 1, all the banks should have achieved their net stable funding ratio target. That is available amount of money to total money required. That is the net stable funding. Net stable funding means whatever the money required for the banks for over the period of time. So that is this net stable funding ratio. So that net stable funding ratio norms target should have achieved 100% by April 1. Now they are increasing the target to be achieved to October 1, 2020. So that is one thing. So net stable funding ratio means it is available amount of stable funding to total amount of stable funding. That is the fund needed by banks to cater their all the dues required. Again, there was this capital conservation buffer issue. Over and above the capital adequacy ratio. See, every bank have to maintain the capital adequacy ratio. Over and above capital adequacy ratio of 9%, over and above this capital adequacy ratio, when the banks are in good period, that is when their banks are in non-crisis time and they are in the good period, they have to allocate additional money of tier 1 capital, that is additional 2.5% for tier 1 capital. You know, capital adequacy ratio is tier 1 capital plus tier 2 capital plus risk weighted assets, net risk weighted asset, total risk weighted asset. So this was 9%. So capital conservation buffer is whenever bank are in the good times, they have to take that money during the good times additionally 2.5% over and above CAR. That is net they have to maintain 11.5% CRR in the good times. Why? In order to, why you are taking the money in the good times? Because you have to save this money in the good times to invest and save yourself from the bad times. When your bank is going to face any bad time in future, you need this additional money. So create a buffer. So why Food Corporation of India is creating buffer? Whenever we are having surplus production, we are keeping that surplus production as buffer, because we have to take that whenever there is a crisis, whenever there is a food security issue or famine issue, we can take that buffer and give it to people, like COVID-19 cases. Similarly, whenever bank is having good time, they have to maintain this additional 2.5 over and above the capital adequacy ratio norm, that is to 11.5, and use that money to tackle the bad times. So that is this capital conservation buffer norms. So banks were given three installments of 0.0625, 0.625, 0.625. In three installments, they have to increase this 2.5%. So already two installments have done, and final 0.625 increase was about to be done by March 31st to 2020. RBI has extended this deadline to September 30, 2020. So by September 30, 2020, it is enough to achieve this capital conservation buffer norms, not by March. See, already the target was March 31st, 2019. So after you know that Section 7 issue and RBI governor, there was a crisis between bank and the government. So after that, this target was postponed to March 31st, 2020. Now it is again being postponed to September 30. So these are all the announcement announced by the RBI in response to the COVID-19 crisis. So now what is going to happen? RBI is going to pump 1 lakh crore under long term repo operation. Additionally 1.37 lakh crore by reduction of CRR, another 1.37 lakh crore by extending the marginal standing facility guidelines. So apart from this, they are also implementing this regulatory and supervisory norms, where people are given flexibility for the repayments of loans. So these are all the steps announced by RBI, and you all should also follow this Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Package. See, on one side, when there is a liquidity crisis, what will happen? On one side, when there is a liquidity crisis, RBI will try to pump liquidity. On another side, government through fiscal policy, they will try to pump in the liquidity. So government is trying to pump in the liquidity through its fiscal policy package of 1.7 lakh crore in the name of Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana. So Garib means poor, Kalyan means welfare. So it is Prime Minister Poor Welfare Package for COVID-19 crisis. So that is the actual translation for this, and this is a factual thing. There is no need of a special explanation for all these things. You can just go to PAB and download the PDF. I have also given the link of the PAB in the description box, so go there and read the factual information. I'll just list down what all they are announced for all the health professionals, from ASHA workers, from the Safai Karmacharis, that is the cleaners in the hospital, to nurses and doctors. Every health worker is given 50 lakh if they are suffering any accident or if there is a loss of life. We saw many doctors lost their life when they were fighting against this COVID-19 in Iran, and we saw many doctors losing their life in Italy. If any doctor is losing their life or facing any accident because of this COVID-19, they are given 50 lakh insurance. So government is insuring all the doctors in order to face this COVID-19. And they have announced another scheme called Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Ann. Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Ann. So Ann means annam. Namma annam nu Tamil la solradha vandu Garib Kalyan Ann. So in this Garib Kalyan Ann, what they are doing, in PDS la already on the National Food Security Act la, government is giving 5 kgs of pulses, wheat and rice at the rate of 3 rupees, 2 rupees and 1 rupee, and you know that story. Apart from that, they are going to give additional 5 kg of wheat. Already they are giving a 5 kg. Now they are going to give additional 5 kg of wheat or rice and 1 kg of preferred pulses. So you can get any preferred pulses based on your regional requirement. Like, one state la one parupu saapiduvaanga. Like, in each state, people will consume each kind of pulse. So, people are given additional 5 kg and 1 kg of rice and pulses in the PDS. then government is going to put in money into. See, COVID-19 is going to take away the jobs of many casual laborers, and we know all the crisis. So government is deciding to put in money into the accounts of people so that to compensate the wage loss whichever they are going to face now. They are going to face the wage loss because of the loss of jobs and layoffs. So to compensate that, they are going to put in money in the women account holders. So they are not going to put the money in the men's account. They are going to put the money in the women account. So women Jandan accounts of up to 500 per month for 3 months. That is, they are going to put up to 1500 in the next 3 months in the women. So this is for women empowerment, because women will be spending money in a rational way. So that is the logic behind it. And in MG Narega, they have increased the wages of 20 rupees. Earlier it was 180 rupees. Now it is going to be minimum 202 rupees per day. So minimum 202 rupees per day. That is going to be the wage under the MG Narega. Again, for the senior citizens, poor widows and poor disabled, government is going to give 1000 rupees. So 1000 rupees as ex gratia. So women are going to get, women Jandan account holder are going to get 1500 in 3 months, and these people are going to get 1000. And government has decided to prepone. Government generally used to pay that 2000 rupees installment. See, in Pradhan Mantri Kisan Yojana, they are going to pay 6000 rupees to small and marginal farmers. So small and marginal farmer will be getting 6000 rupees in 3 installments of 2k each. So 2k, 2k, 2k. So first installment of 2k generally they will be giving in June month. So government is preponing it, and they are planning it to give in April. So farmers will be having money in their account. Again, government is has ordered the state government to use the funds under the building consideration welfare fund. So according to the building construction welfare, so building construction workers welfare act 1996, so parliament passed this act, building construction and welfare of building construction workers welfare act 1996. Under this, for each construction project, 1% of the total project cost will be levied as building construction welfare cess, building construction workers welfare cess. So if the project cost of a construction project is 100 crore, government will impose 1%, that is 1 crore should be paid to government as building construction worker welfare cess. So to the state government, so state government will be levying this cess. So all the construction project, 1% of the construction cost they will be paying as the cess, and this money will be deposited in the building and construction workers welfare fund of each state. So each state will be having their own, so it is state, each state is having their own building construction workers welfare fund, where 1% of the money collected through the cess will be deposited here, and this money should be used by the state government for the welfare of the construction workers. So central government has given orders to the state government to use this money to provide relief to the construction workers, because there is not going to be any construction work. So this construction work will be, workers will be losing their daily wages. So state governments are asked to take the money from this thing and spend there. Again, you know, there is something called District Mineral Foundation, where each person who is getting the, you know, District Mineral Foundation, each miner have to allocate certain percentage of the money and the District Mineral Foundation fund. So this District Mineral Foundation fund will be used for welfare of the miners on the same lines as this building and construction worker welfare fund. So now each District Mineral Foundation will be having the fund for the welfare of miners. So state government are given power to take money from that account and spend for the welfare of the COVID-19 crisis. So this is the fiscal package announced by the government. See, on one side RBI is announcing, on another side government is announcing. So all this money is going to be pumped into the economy, and this will revive the economy. So now I'll tell another, again I'll repeat the same thing. Economy will go towards boom, recession, depression and recovery. So we all know that this is the business cycle. So because of already existing, we are having already existing slowdown, and now we are having COVID-19. So these both the crisis might push our economy to the recession. So in if we are not taking steps to prevent the recession, that might lead to depression. Depression means negative growth, that is GDP growth itself is falling. So we have to take steps here. If you are not taking it, it will lead to depression. So government is taking steps to revive the economy from the recession towards the recovery. So hence the government has taken this. So, you know, see, after seeing this video, you go to the links given in the description box. In that links, I have given, I'll give the PDFs for the both steps taken by RBI and step taken by the government. You just go through it and understand all the concept. Now, whatever concept we studied already has been touched now. CRR, SLR, MSF, and repo operations. All these things are facing some changes because of this recent announcement. So, be updated before the 2020 prelims. So, all the best students. Thank you. Be safe. Be safe in home. Stay home. Stay safe. Maintain social distancing. Let us together face this coronavirus crisis and let us overcome this coronavirus crisis by staying at home. Study well. Use this time to preparation for the prelims. Now, we are lucky. We are getting a certain extra time for studying prelims. So, let us use this time to crack this examination. Thank you.